Hi everyone, this is Gloria with StampWithGloria.com. Today we're going to work on our paper pumpkin for August. It's a beautiful paper pumpkin, and there was lots of elements to it. It was pretty easy to put together. I'm just going to show you a couple of alternatives and then talk about what I did and maybe show you a little bit of a technique. But of course, you know, you get all the goodies in the paper pumpkin, and I've mentioned this before, but I'll mention it again if you're new. On the back of your paperwork that you get in your paper pumpkin box, you will see everything that's supposed to be in your kit. If for some reason you don't see some of these elements in your kit, just give demonstrator support a call or your demonstrator a call, and give Stamping Up a call or your demonstrator a call, and then we'll be happy to include whatever's missing in your kit. But as you see, there's envelopes, a lot of tags, the cards themselves that are beautifully done again with some really beautiful colors. Another thing I want to point out on here, and I did circle it and I need to use my glasses in order to read these, but right underneath the kit components, it also tells you what coordinating Stamping Up colors, so that's like cardstock, inks, ribbons, would coordinate with this particular paper pumpkin kit. So right here, this kit has Bermuda Bay, Blackberry Bliss, Bumblebee, Melon Mambo, Petal Pink, Pool Party, and Poppy Parade. So you can add those colored elements in those different types of accessories into your paper pumpkin kit to do, you know, some fun things. So that's what we're going to do today. So inside the kit, you have your rubber stamps. It's all about hope. It's all about, you know, giving people warm fuzzies and hugs, and just a note that you're thinking about them. It has some butterflies in it, some background elements, and then, of course, the same. So it's a lovely kit. I like it very much. And as I said before, it was a dream to put together. It was pretty easy. Like I said, it was so pretty, I didn't really have to do a lot as far as additional alternatives to this card kit. But, you know, you can come up with things on your own. So, and then, I don't know if you can see that. Yep, see, that's the envelope that comes with it. I'm going to show you something that you can do with a little detail on this in just a little bit. So, why don't we get started? I'm going to show you some of the cards that I did. Now, the kit itself came with everything to do this particular card. Oh, the pretties. I didn't have the pretties out here, but you got the pretties in the card kit. These are all punch-outs. You have your Blackberry Bliss stamp pad, and then this saying was in there. So all of these elements came in your card kit. You can make this card just with the elements that came in your card kit. So pretty easy, lots of fun. Here is another one. This one is the same thing, elements within your card kits, including this beautiful cutout. See the butterflies and the flowers in the background? Really, really pretty. But that came in the kit, so it was just easy to tack down, put some pretties on. This particular, I was thinking, you know, with the hope theme, it was nice that I still have this, and you might be able to find it online, but you can do this with regular ribbon too. I didn't have any pink ribbon, so I thought, oh, okay. Well, I used this dye that we had in, we discontinued in 2020, but it's the support ribbon framelits dye, and so it had two sizes of ribbons in there. I use them a lot for the military too when I make cards. The military ribbon color is yellow, and of course the breast cancer awareness for October, which is coming up, is pink. So you could turn all of these cards into breast cancer awareness cards easy by just taking some regular pink ribbon and putting it on there. So I was thinking about that coming up. Got a couple of friends where that would be appropriate. Then I did use the smaller version of the ribbon here for military. I do have a friend who's just passed from the military, and it's something I wanted to recognize, and I thought this was just a great way to do this. Again, everything here except for this little ribbon was in the kit. And how I made the cross is I just cut one of the banners a little bit smaller. And then on the background here, I embossed in white the flower that comes in the kit. So I'll show you the flower. I know it looks different when it's on the background, but this paper came in the kit, and then I embossed this flower here in the background multiple times to get that look. So just adding a little bit here, a little bit there. And this is for, like I said, a friend of mine that passed away in the military, for their family, I guess. And then just a note of hope, all of these elements were in the stamp, the card kit. So this background element, what I did is I stamped it in Blackberry Bliss so that we got just a little bit of contrast there. And then you see the pretties I put on there. And then I popped up the banners with dimensionals just to give it a little like three-dimensional look. So right there's another alternative. Sorry, my voice is going a little bit. I don't know if it's allergies or a bad cold, but I've been really trying to get over this, and it's prevented me from doing this video, and now time has run out because I'm going to be traveling pretty soon. I'm going to be, it's my 35th wedding anniversary on September 6th, so my husband planned a getaway, which, 35 years, that's a miracle. I mean, it's a whole week. You know, we've planned getaways for a weekend, but it's a whole week. So I'm really excited about that. But we leave next week, so I wanted to get this video out before I left. And then after that, I'm going to go see my grandbaby for 2 weeks in Virginia. I want to point out that this job is great for things like that, for, you know, when you get older, you know, when you're younger and you have kids, it does let you work around their schedules, stamping up does, because you make your own hours, right? But when you're older and you have grandbabies and they live far away, like all of my grandbabies do, then I have the ability to continue to run my business in a remote location, but still am able to have that time with my grandbabies, which I really, really appreciate. So this is another card. It's using that pretty background again, and it's got some more pretties on it, some butterflies, and then these little tags, you see they came in there. I just stamped portions of the words, and then put the hope in the middle and made this card. So everything is included in the kit for this one. Another pretty, pretty card. Then I thought it would be fun to design a card with maybe some dies I have. And right now we're in celebration, and one of the dies that we have one of the dies that we have that's free with a $50 order is the Summer Shadow Dies. Okay, so you can get this free with a $50 order. Now let me grab the stamp set so you can see it. Now this stamp set that it goes with is in our catalog, is in our annual catalog, but the dies are not there. So if you have this set or you think you want this set, we'll place a $50 order and pick this set up. The set by itself, except for, you know, the outline images, you can use on just about anything. So if you don't care for the set and you just like the flowers and the leaves and stuff, this is a perfect way to show you how they work, because here's that flower right there. Okay, and then it's the two images that, oops, can you see? It's the two images here that make this bigger flower here. So super fun, right? Now, you might have not have noticed this in the other cards that I showed you, but Stampin' Up! Did a really good job of, see how they color coordinated underneath to give the cutout some shadowing and stuff. Really great idea. And I'm going to show you another way to do that. But that it was such a cool idea, and but when you take away that element, that die cut, then you have all these really pretty background kind of fading in the distance going on. And like when I started, I was looking at the different colors that would match with this particular kit. And so Petal Pink, Pool Party, Poppy Parade, Bumblebee, you know, this actually is the glimmer paper, the rainbow glimmer paper. I have a lot of that left, or I have a lot of scraps since I did my son is getting married, and I did a Walt Disney I did a castle in the rainbow glimmer, and that's part of their save the date cards. So I had a lot of that because we had to make a lot of invitations. So anyway, I had some of that left, and I put that on there. I did pop one up to get some dimensional, and I used the glimmer paper around the outline too, so the darker portion of the glimmer paper to give it some pop, and then the hope. But you know, these elements are in the kit, so this was just adding a couple of fun things with that free die set that I got during celebration here. Okay, now this next one, again, all of these elements on the front of the card are beautiful. They're in the kit, and they're stamps. I used the Rich Razzleberry to stamp here. Hope, I brought out that color there. Let's see, what color is that? You know, Petal Pink. I brought the color out. Oh no, not Petal Pink. What am I thinking? You can't see it very well, but this is Poppy Parade. Okay, that's one of the colors in the kit. But it doesn't look like Poppy Parade on this video, but it is, and it looks gorgeous in person. But here's the Poppy Parade here. But anyway, banners again, the butterflies, some pretties. This card you can make totally with the kit. Now remember the die cut. This is what the die cut looks like. Okay, and we had that on another card. Let me pull that out. There was, I think, 4 of these die cuts in the kit. So I wanted to show you a different way that you could use the die cut. So I wanted it to pop up when the card was opened. And I wanted the background to be like that pretty rainbow look with the butterflies and the pretties. Again, this stuff is in the card kit. And then, but I didn't want the back to be white, and it is white because normally you would stick this portion down. I'm going to show you how to color it in just a second. And then I'm going to show you how to make this little middle part of the card so that when you open the card, isn't that pretty? So I have that pretty rainbow background and the butterfly, and then you can put your message here, right? So I just add this. Actually, this whole card was portions of, I actually cut, this was a card, and then I cut off the top of it and used that portion for something else in this kit. Oh, I used it for inside here. And then had this portion up here so that we could do this. So super fun, right? And then this is just a white piece. This right here is just a white piece of cardstock that I cut and did it. But anyway, let me show you how to do this. I'm talking too much, and I'm sure you're going, I'm not understanding. So since I used all of my die cuts, I needed a new die cut to show you how to do this particular card. And I cut that out of basic white and the many layered blossoms die. So here's that die. Okay, it's right there, right? Now, how do we get the color on that? Well, again, we want to take the colors that are part of the kit. So I've got Bumblebee here, and Fresh Freesia, and Melon Mambo. Okay, so we took these three colors. All right. And then we have the brayers, the foam brayers in the catalog. And they're super fun to work with. And you just, you know, you get like 6 of the foam, the foam part in a kit when you buy it in two handles. And then you just, when you want to use it, you just pull it out, okay, and then tuck it back in again. There you go. All right, and then you want to ink up your roller or your brayer, okay, and then you're just going to take and you can bray a portion of your cutout here, okay? You don't have to go in a straight line. You can go at an angle, okay? So on this particular card here, okay, this is one of them that I did and I colored. I did different angles, okay? But I wanted, like, Rich Razzleberry, I wanted it to come closer to the Rich Razzleberry on the card stock so that it kind of matched with that color. And so, see, Bumblebee is underneath that flower, so I braid that Bumblebee. Okay, let me show you that. So here I'm going to take the Bumblebee, and we're going to just braid the Bumblebee. See how that goes? And you can do, like I said, you can do portions. So I only did, you know, a couple sides. And we're going to flip that over. This, I'm going to just do this in a, you know, kind of a ombre, I guess, blending into colors. So there's the second section. And then we're going to go for Fresh Freesia and finish up this side. Isn't that pretty? But it's just super easy to do. Okay, and so now we're going to have some purple here and some purple here. So if you were trying to, like, if you, like, maybe watercolored the background or maybe use the sponge on another background, you could do that easily. See how that's done? So now we've got, isn't that cool? All right. I know, right? So much fun. I love it. So you can do that with a dauber or two. You can do that with a sponge. You do not need the brayers, okay, to do this particular technique. Lots of different ways. Oh, look, that came off of the back. Look, you see. Yeah, came off the back of my stamp pad. You know, every time I do a video, I think something goes crazy on it, and then I'm like, what? Oh. One other thing I wanted to show you. Okay, so we've got that there. You can also use cutouts as a stencil. So I noticed that on our cart, see right there, let's see if I can get the camera to focus. The yellow and orange isn't allowing you to see it very well. But right here, I couldn't figure out how the envelope got that. Okay, and then I'm like, oh, they used it as a stencil. So you can also use the cutouts as a stencil. So we're going to just stencil this right here. Okay, we're not going to be fancy or anything like that. We'll just put some yellow on it. And then look, you get that really cool flower there. You get that really cool stencil look, right? I know, it's so exciting. All right, so now how did we put that one card together? Well, in this case, I wanted Melon Mambo as part of the background. So I had a piece of Melon Mambo cardstock, and then what I did is cut out a regular size card. Okay, so it would be 5.5, right? So we cut out 5.5, all right? And then I rotated it. Okay, so if we start with an 8.5 sheet of paper, you're going to cut it in half first. Then you'll end up with half a card, or like one card. So you're going to cut it like that, cut your 8.5 by 11 in half. All right. Then I scored it at 4.25, okay, right there, see the score, right? And then I just cut it off at 1 inch. So I moved it over and then cut it off 1 inch. So let me show you how to do that. So I've got this card here and I just want the 1 inch mark. So there's the 1 inch mark right there, all right? So I'm gonna line that up. Good. And then I'm just gonna cut that off. So we cut that right off. All right. Then I have the two pieces, and we're gonna have to reverse the fold on the top piece. Does that make sense? Okay, and then the two pieces, oh, what am I doing? We'll reverse the fold on the bottom piece, okay, and then open it up. And then right here, we're gonna put some adhesive, okay, and I'm just using the line adhesive here. You can use, and the reason you want to put it on both sides is because there's two sides to the stencil or to the die, right? And so if you just put it on one side, then the other side won't stick. That makes sense, right? So we're gonna just tuck. Well, if you want to do it this way, a lot of people will want to do it this way because they want to line up everything. So you're going to line it up so that it's all within the white cardstock, you know, so that you can tuck it into an envelope, right? You don't want hanging out the edge. All right. And then we're going to just tuck it together, right? And then we have a new card that will pop up with you. And then, you know, maybe you can add some of these pieces that are left. Say a nice sand. There we go. That's still part of the cardstock. And you've made another card. I don't like it. How pretty is that? I know, I love it. I love it, I love it, I love it. Okay, so this is another card I made for breast cancer awareness. Banners, everything was in there except for the pink ribbon, which you can easily add. So that's another card. So those are all of the cards that I did. Let me just show them to you. I'll just bring them all back into the picture here quick so you can see how pretty they all are. I know, right? I know. This was such a fun kit to do. And it hit so many, the sentiments were great to hit so many different occasions, right? Breast cancer awareness, you know, encouragement, my military friend's passing. So really fun cards, really easy to put together really fast. Now, let me talk about one thing here. Oh! Before I talk about this, let me talk about something else. In this kit, they did have another feature to it this month. Okay, so this this kit had another butterfly that you could punch out. These are how the cutouts come. They come in a sheet. You just pull them all out, and then you use them. Okay, so we're going to pull all these out. And this month, they included, we call these belly bands, okay? And what we're going to do is we would put all these items together around the box, and let's say you're going to give all these cards to someone as a gift. Then you can make the card the gift box. Does that make sense? So let's take our box. Let's tuck out this, get some of this out here. So we would shut the box, and then we could do fun stuff with this belly band. We could stamp it, we could stencil it, you know, so take one of those, we could stencil it with the butterfly even. I mean, it would just, it wouldn't really affect the color of the butterfly at all. But we could totally do something like that. So the pink's on there, so you could like kind of lay it a little bit conky. It does come with a tag. And then these pretties you just add kind of randomly around the box. Oops. Before we do that, though, you want to finish off the belly band with the ribbon. So you would take the ribbon, right, like this. The reason I'm not putting this all together is because I want to use this as a gift box. And if I put it all together for you, then it'll be stuck, and then I won't be able to give it to my friend. So there you go. So then you put a tag there, and our pretties up here. You could add more sequins. And we've got another element that goes on the tag right there. And now you've got a gift box that you can give to someone. So super fun, right? Super fun this month. Really loved the kit. Love the colors. Love the ease in which I could put everything together. And I used every element in the kit. So there's nothing left for me to use with other kits. But that's a good point to point out is a lot of times Stampin' Up! Is very generous with all of the items that they have in the kit, and you have leftovers, and you certainly can use them with other paper pumpkin kits as you go along. So speaking about that, so I showed you some alternatives, and I want to show you how easy it is to become a demonstrator and use some of these alternative ideas and do your own kits. So like with me, and there's not just me, but there's many demonstrators out there that do alternatives. They do alternative videos. If you like my videos, I try to do a paper pumpkin one every month. I'll do the video, maybe not in the same month, but I try to get to it. But let me just show you a couple of things. So for this particular kit, let's say you wanted to do it with a friend, okay? So the friend is going to, you know, get the Blackberry Bis stamp pad, and then everything in the kit that you need to do what I just showed you to do, right? And let's say you wanted to do some of the extras. So let's say you bought two kits. Let's say you wanted to become a demonstrator. We're just, you know, hypothetical thinking about this. Let's say you become a demonstrator. It's $44 for two paper pumpkin kits you can share with a friend. You want to share with a friend. Then you get a couple of stamp pads, and these are pretty colors. Bumblebee, Fresh Freesia, and Melon Mambo. Okay, they're $7.50 each. And then that Blossoms die, you can use that independently all by itself. You do not need the set to go with it. Okay, so this is such a neat set because you can get, you can punch out the solid image of the flowers and layer them with this line image and make some beautiful cards. And then there's more flowers to pop out on it. Okay, so let's say you've got the many layered Blossoms dies, okay, to go with it. Melon Mambo cardstock. So that's the pinker cardstock that I used with the last card, which I thought kind of gave it a really nice pop. So this pink is Melon Mambo. Alright. Some multi-purpose glue, just in case you need some. And the kit is $99, but you picked out $125 worth of Stampin' Up! Merchandise. Whatever you want, you pick it out. And so this comes up to $124.25, okay? The kit's $99. That's what you're going to pay, is $99. Now this month, during celebration, till the end of the month, you also get to pick an extra bundle, okay? So let me show you that. So for $125, you have the option of picking all of these different bundles. There's Frosted Gingerbread, Christmas Season, Christmas to Remember, Whimsical Trees. Let me show you just Whimsical Trees just really quick. That has been a really popular one I have seen on the internet everywhere. Let's see. It's on page 13, page 25. Let me show you how beautiful this set is. But you could get this set for Christmas for free, all right? And the cool thing is, it uses a lot, they show it in pinks, and that is like the Melon Mambo. There's some yellow in it here. I don't know, can you see yellow? So you can use the Bumblebee, the pinks, the Fresh Freesia, here's Fresh Freesia. You can use that in this set, and it coordinates with all these papers. That's a bundle. You don't need that. But what you get is the stamp set and the dies. That's the bundle. Or here's another one. Let me show you if you're not into Christmas yet. There's fall. Okay. So this is another bundle that you can get for free. Let me go to that page right here. Look at this. Gorgeous, huh? This is a card that I made with it. All right. I love this card. But the other thing I wanted to show you is hope this card makes you smile. That's actually also free with a $50 order during celebration. So, you know, you could become a demonstrator for $125, get all of that stuff I just mentioned, and then go back in as a demonstrator, get a discount, and then buy a couple of extra things, spend another $50, get this really in your own words, this really neat, this neat word set, or spend $100 and then get the dies that I used with the alternatives today. So, I mean, if you like crafts and you want to get like a bonanza of stuff for $100, then become a demonstrator. And it's so easy. Just go to stampwithgloria.com and it says join me. And click on that icon and pick out the stuff that you need and join me, and you'll have all of these items that you need. And then in every consecutive month, I can show you another video with Paper Pumpkin and Paper Pumpkin alternatives. You can do it with a friend, add friends, and you'll continue to make all of these beautiful cards for all these different occasions. It's kind of like art without anxiety, because these paper pumpkin kits, when they're all inclusive like this, including the stamp pad, it can't get any better than that. I mean, you can put together all of these cards in an afternoon, and they're beautiful cards that you can send out to anyone for any occasion. And like I said, I kind of remade these cards to fit a couple of special occasions, more than one. And I just love them. It's just so great. So think about it. Join me at stampwithgloria.com. And I'd love to have you, but like I said, super easy way for you to do this, plus an extra bundle this month during celebration, till the end of the month, okay? So, you know, think about that, and if you've been wanting some craft items, then this is the way to go. It's the best month to do it during celebration. So, thanks for spending some time with me this afternoon. I've enjoyed our talk. I'm in Wisconsin, so it's quite dreary and raining, and like I said, I've got this allergy thing going on, and I turn 58 in 2 days. I feel old, and then my anniversary is the day after. 35 years with the same man. I don't know. What's that all about? Just like the same man. Just going to throw that out there at you. But anyway, must be the end. I'm going to start coughing away again. So anyway, you guys have a great day. Have a great Labor Day weekend. Think about this. This would have been some fun activity to do with a gathering during Labor Day weekend. But, you know, we've got Thanksgiving coming up. Think about it. You guys have a great day, and I'll talk to you soon.